Nathan, have you got a boyfriend? I'm not really asking. You don't have to say, but it's not about being gay.
I'm not all right.
What are you going to do? What are you going to tell her?
I can't.
You'll have to.
Yeah, Stuart and Vince.
Cameron Roberts, I did Phil's accounts.
As a matter of fact, I'm dead good looking. I was told.
Well, you are.
Aye, aye, Bernie. One of yours.
You won't shift him tonight. Clever little bugger.
Yeah, well, if we can get him home tonight, you're coming with me. I'm not going on my own.
Take him. It's his fault.
Fuck off, Vince. Move, I've got work. Oi! I said out!
And you.
Sun goes down tonight, 19 minutes to 5.
Right, come on. Shift your ass. To sign on. 4 days to go till the Corps playing live, that's this Monday. That was alright last night, wasn't it? Bit of a laugh. Am I gonna see you again or what?
You can see me now.
Oh, fuck off.
Call the police! Mad children on the loose!
You know what's the bet? They do recognise you. Go on, Thomas, say your piece.
Mum says your phone's broke. You never call back.
Well, you tell your mother that she's not clever and she's not funny.
Bye, Stuart.
See you, Stu.
See ya.
Who are they?
Those nice men just popped in to fix your uncle's plumbing.
Is that my shirt? Is it ironed? Is there any hot water? I met this bloke in Paradise Factory. Thought he was a nice guy and woke up this morning.
You could have been dead. Your mother's on the way round. Do you want me to tell her? She's hanging on to this by the skin of her teeth. I tell her what you've been doing, she'll have you back home even if she has to call the police. Do you want me to tell her? Do you?
No.
Anything else to say?
Sorry.
You're in this house on a favour, Sunshine. Don't piss me off. Hi!
Sorry I'm late.
Here he is. Scrubbed and pressed. See you tonight.
I don't know why you bother.
Oh, that's for the shop. And a bit extra, just in case he needs any pens. He likes ball pencils, but don't buy more than two at once. He's always losing them.
Tonight? It's not much warning, is it?
Oh, no. I did ask Louise, but ever since her dad went, they think I'm going to disappear too. A few babies said they'll be so excited, they'd hardly notice I'm gone.
What's his name?
Malcolm. Don't laugh. He's from the same office. He's a bit of an idiot, really. He's got these really funny teeth. But he asked me, yeah, it's good enough for me.
It's just work. I'm up to my eyes. Can you ask Mum?
I'll tell her I have a date.
Good point.
Sure, we go on dates. You know, like proper sit down for dinner dates.
Yeah, yeah. I did once. Shagged the waiter. Okay. I'll do it.
I'll pick you up usual time.
Don't give me a lift. It's embarrassing.
If you'd rather not be embarrassed, then you know what to do. Come over tonight, then. Just come over for your tea. Your sister would love to see you. And there won't be any trouble. I'll pick you up tonight. I'm not giving up, Nathan. I'm not walking out.
There's an offer on coffee. 2 for 1. Might as well stock up.
and you get double the points on your card.
Oh, get us a box of Weetabix.
Thought your breakfast was 20 Bensons.
It's for little Lord Fauntleroy.
I'm not shopping for him. What else does he want? Party rings, Angel Delight, nappies.
Get me a big box of Surf. I've got double the laundry. It's all bed sheets. I'd forgotten how much teenage boys masturbate.
Mom?
Stiff as a board.
Hazel, don't wash him, I'll have
him. Bernard says don't wash him, he'll have him.
It's like an 0898 number. I'll bring this stuff round in the afternoon and we're having words about this Nathan business. It's been a fortnight now. It's ridiculous. Excuse me, sir. Sue, put that on staff discount and put my name on it, Tar.
You're busy, I'll just go.
Oh, my God. Sorry. Yeah.
Cameron Roberts, we met at Phil's funeral.
Yeah, of course we did. Sorry. Vince.
I know.
Well, bit of a coincidence.
Not really. Phil told me you worked here, so I came looking. Just thought you might fancy dinner tonight.
Sorry, sort of not at work, you know?
Is that a yes or a no?
I don't know. I might be doing all sorts.
It's all right, no pressure. Here's my card. Think about it.
Yeah, right. Nice card.
Come on. So why has it got to be me?
Now, it's dull as ditch water. Wife and three kids, one at Oxford, blah, blah, blah. So no shock tactics, just behave. Nice meal, couple of brandies, and get him to sign.
Martin.
Stuart, I've heard a lot about you.
All of it lies. Now, Sandra can book us a restaurant, or she can check out Bridgewater Hall if you'd like to take in a concert. Excuse me.
There's a production of Twelfth Night.
So we're talking now.
Shut your face. Complete emergency. I've been asked out on a date.
Do you remember Cameron Roberts? We were stood by the buffet. He was taller than you. Australian.
Oh, yeah, the blind Australian. Was he nice?
Well, like he used to be nice when he was young. But he's what? At least 36. And he's an accountant, so he's probably going to sell me a pension. Phil's dead, so he's got a gap in his books.
Take the initiative. Seduce him over the portfolios.
There's other things I could be doing. Like throwing that kid out of my mother's house. Thought you might apologise. Of course not.
Day like that, you need a shag at the end of it.
The trouble is, he's waiting for the next shag. So he's going to stop at Hazel's till he gets it.
Why does it bother you?
Because every time I go around Hazel's, there he is. She's cooking him tea. Same old story. It's like that Alan Lucas. He falls in love with you and ends up locking himself in my bathroom. Bolts the door and everything. Said he wouldn't shift till you come round. He was in there 3 hours. He was eating toothpaste. I couldn't use my own toilet. I had to piss in the sink. That's what happens because of you. I end up pissing in my own
sink. Mr. Roberts. Yes, I've got Mr. Tyler here for you. Putting you through.
Hi. It's Vince, yeah. No, he's a trainee. A bit useless. I'm sort of busy. I'll give you a call in a week. No, the thing is, I'm really sort of... All right, then. Okay. I'm having dinner. 8 o'clock tonight. Yes!
He's got a date!
I've got a pension! You bastard!
Now, the concert begins at 8, so I'll pick you up about 10 to 8.
I did think... I mean, the concert. But I thought we'd have a touch more fun, you know, if... We went to your sort of place.
My sort of place?
Your sort of place.
Jesus Christ, is there no one straight left in the world? Martin, twist my arm!
And the history project, when's it due?
Monday.
Right, I'll take a look at it Sunday night. Is that all right with you?
Fine, come for tea.
It's like having two mothers.
And whose fault is that? Give it time. We'll wear him down. Hmm? I've bandaged Enders. He's livid.
It's very simple, Janice. You go upstairs, you pack his bags, shove him in the car and take him home. Who's in charge? You or him?
It says London. Every time I try, it says London, and it could. Plenty of boys his age just take off and...
He likes it here too much. While he's here, he's safe.
I just don't know why. What have I done wrong?
He's 15, that's all. Happens all over, Janice. Some boys don't come out of the closet. They explode.
What about his dad? Can't he do anything?
He won't talk about it. Won't talk at all. Not one word. I can't tell anyone. And even if I tell his school, they'll tell social services. Well, they'll have to. And then there's Helen. She's 10 years old. What happens to her? She gets interviewed. She gets a name on a register at 10 years old.
No, they wouldn't, love. All they'd do is visit.
Oh, you'd know, wouldn't you? I'm sorry, I didn't mean... Got it wrong, didn't I? Somewhere along the line, I got it all wrong. But he'll be all right, won't he? I mean, if he's out on Canal Street, keep an eye on him, could you?
Of course I will.
Thanks, I'd better... Thank you.
Oh, well done, Vincent. Reduce a grown woman to tears. Like no one's talked to her till you come blundering in. What's the matter with you?
I've got a date. No, I don't want a pension. Cameron, just stop right there. No pension. No. It's all your fault. If I end up with life insurance and endowment policies and stocks and shares and things, you're paying for it, all right? Where are you, anyway?
We're going to Via Fossa. I've got a new friend. His name's Martin, so you won't be missed.
Thanks a lot. Oh, my God. I'm here. I'm going in.
Good luck. Keep your phone on, and Vince, just remember one thing. You're fantastic.
I'm a fantastic twat.
What about the Rembrandts? Is that still going?
Yeah, I go there, and Via Fossa, and the Union, and Mantos, and Mets, and Napoleons, New York, and Cruise, and Babylon, and Paradise. I'm poptastic. Just every now and then.
I think that makes you officially a scene queen.
I'm not. I just go out a lot. How come you don't?
What is there on that street that could surprise me?
Yeah, but if you don't go down there, how are you going to meet someone?
Hello?
Right, yeah. You having a starter? I'm not. I never have a starter. Yes, I will. I'm starving. I'm having a starter. Blimey! Look at all these starters, hundreds of them. Where's that wine?
See anyone you like?
There is one.
Which one?
I know him.
All right.
Sorry. I don't suppose that wouldn't, not in a million years, but I'll sign the contract if you're prepared to. I mean it. I will. I'll sign. If.
That was my boyfriend on the phone, Vince. He's seen his accountant tonight.
I'll sign it anyway. Sorry.
Tell you what about him? See? Tall, blonde one. He's up for anything. I'll put in a good word for you.
How old is he?
15.
15? It's a bit revolting, isn't it?
Absolutely.
Nathan, look. I can see you now. Bet you can't remember my name, you dirty shagger. You hang around for a bit?
No, where am I going?
We're not. We just got here.
We're going, all right?
Nathan, love, calm down. This might come as a shock. But I'm not in love with you. You're quite safe. I'll be back in a minute. I'll have dry martini. It's Daniel, by the way.
from last night? Daniel, the 6'2" barrister with the BMW.
No, that's a different Daniel.
It's a nightmare. Says he's 36, the liar. I'm sitting here with an old man. It's like the auditions for Cocoon 3.
Tell him that story about the broken leg. That always works.
Is that Vince? Say hello for me.
Some twat says hello.
Is that Nathan? Stuart, listen, his mum had a right go at me. Do us a favour, keep an eye on him.
Never mind him. Just think about yourself for once.
We could go somewhere afterwards. I don't know. Is Cruise open? You're the expert.
Yeah. Listen, I've got to make this call. There's this boy and no one's looking after him. It's a bit of a crisis. You don't mind? Stuart, seriously, it's your fault he's left home. You can wander off at anywhere.
Hold on, call waiting. Yeah.
Thank you, Stuart. Thank you so much. I've had Ben crying his eyes out. That's all he needs, another man to abandon him.
I did phone Marie. I left a message. It's an emergency. I've got to work.
In a bar, I can hear it. How many dates do you think I get anyway, a mother with two kids?
Hold on, call waiting. Yeah?
Are you with Martin Brooks? Because his mobile's switched off. His wife's on the phone. She's had the roof fall in or something.
Martin, it's your wife.
I'm not here.
He's not here.
Call waiting. He's a busy man.
Look, I hope you don't mind, but could you put it down just for a minute?
Yeah, sure. Sorry.
Right. Because if you want to go clubbing, I could...
I'm sorry. It's this boy. I promised his mother. Hello?
Vince, he's kept me waiting long enough. Now put him on the phone.
I'm not with Stuart.
You're always with him. I was supposed to be on a date and he's ruined it.
Marie, honestly, I'm not. Hold on. Call waiting. Yeah?
Vince, put him on. I know full well he's taken Martin Brooks to some godforsaken dive.
I'm not with Stuart.
His wife's going mental.
Whose wife?
Martin Brooks.
Who the hell is Martin Brooks? Hold on. Call waiting. What?
You hung up on me.
Are you and Martin Brooks?
How do you know Martin Brooks?
I've got Sandra chasing Martin Brooks.
I've never heard of Martin Brooks.
Hold on. He's not with Martin Brooks.
Who the hell is Martin Brooks?
Sorry, wrong one. Hold on. Sandra, no Martin Brooks.
He is with Martin Brooks and his roof has fallen in.
Whose roof's fallen in?
Martin Brooks.
Hold on. Marie, is your date with Martin Brooks?
Who the fuck is Martin Brooks?
I don't know, but he's got a wife and a dodgy roof.
Wait a minute, I know Martin Brooks. Let me have a word.
Oi! That's my phone!
Call me.
What with? Bastard accountants.
Sweetheart, I've missed you.
I'm stocking up on this aftershave.
I kind of said you've had it. Well, that's the last you'll see of him. He's a chicken arc. Chase after you, buy your dinner, all that. Must have shagged you. I'm not looking at you.
Yeah, well, I've had him twice.
He never bought you dinner.
Do you like him?
He's all right.
Oh, like Nathan's not completely in love.
Words of advice, Nathan. He can swan about, but there's one thing sharp. He's not young, and he knows it. Your age, you can make him beg.
What's your name?
Adrian.
Adrian.
Martin.
Martin.
Adrian.
Off you go.
Waste of time. He didn't even like me.
He must have liked you.
No shag. He's gay. We go out on a date. Where's the shag? I don't give a toss. See that bloke over there? He's been looking. I'm going over.
He asked you out. He kissed you.
And then he went home. It's unnatural.
Vince, is it so hard to believe that someone fancies you?
I don't care. I'm shagging. I am. Sorry, do you mind shutting your mouth a bit?
Yeah, sure.
It's just a bit more sexy if you keep your mouth shut a bit.
Yeah, sure. Oh, my God, you've got Genesis of the Daleks.
Yeah.
Oh, can we watch it?
We can watch it after, yeah?
Oh, can we watch it now? Please?
Davros! Exterminate! Exterminate!
No!
Exterminate!
Cosright, no. This is the first time Davros ever appeared. He's manipulating the war between the Kalids and the Thal so his own creations can survive.
Oh, no.
Because they were the first Daleks ever. And they weren't even called Daleks, they were called the Mark III Travel Machine.
I know. It's my tape.
Three more episodes. Molto bene, molto!
The supreme creature, the ultimate conqueror of the universe, the Dalek!
It was all right. It was nice. Apart from the spitting. I suppose you got lucky. Good clubs, though. Must be marvellous doing that all the time.
Do you think?
Should be good tonight.
What time is your trainer?
Oh, I'll call and cancel. I'll tell Anne I've got to work.
Fine. Cancel. Go out, get pissed, get shagged. Fine. Then you can do it again. Then you can do it again. Get shagged every night of your life. Forget your wife. Forget your kids. Just don't be a tourist. You either do it or you don't. So what's it gonna be? Staying or going?
My train's at 5:30.
They're all talking. Amanda Boyce has started.
What did she say?
She says, how come Nathan Maloney doesn't walk to school anymore? And Chinese Susan chips in. She says, he's never at home. It's like there's a divorce or something.
What did you say?
I said nothing. I says I don't know.
That is brilliant.
That's not brilliant. Listen, school find out about this and you'll have education welfare down your back. It happened to Billy Valentine. They put him in care. He disappeared. He went to Cardiff and he had real problems.
I've got real problems.
Oh, like what? Like your mother's been going through your things. Big deal.
She knew everything. She'd been spying.
So? She's your mother. It's a job.
I actually think if I move back home, I'll go back to normal. Like I'm sick and like I'll get better.
She never said that.
Donna, you don't know her. You don't know anything. Because you're straight, right? You're part of the system, right? You're part of the fascist, heterosexual orthodoxy.
I'm black and I'm a girl. Try that for a week.
Right, I'm late. I'm on the midday shift.
You've got the seeds of death. It's a classic.
I'll come round and watch it sometime. Is that all right?
Yeah.
Well, bye. Beware the Mentiats.
I took him to Alderley Edge. He loved it.
Vince's not with you.
Should he be?
I'm talking to Alfred. We've had a great afternoon. We've been entertaining another one of your babies.
Helen was 5, I was 10. She used to ride piggyback, but she'd always grab my hair. Hiya.
What are you doing here?
I was passing. We're just saying, weekends, I could look after Alfred. You know, babysit. Because you're at work all week. You must be worn out at your age.
We like Nathan. Nathan can stay. It's great. It's like having a houseboy. He can do the garden. It's the Stuart Jones Foundation for Fallen Boys. Bob a job week.
Can I help it if he's obsessed?
Oh, yeah. Obsessed at 15. What does that make you? Hornby train set. PlayStation.
Oh, sorry. Am I interrupting?
Don't be daft.
This must be Stuart. Heard all about you, mate.
I've heard nothing about you, mate.
Lance Ampoma. Nice to meet you.
I have told you. Lance works at the university. We did that seminar on ethics. If you listened. He's moved in. He's got the room at the back. He's our token straight.
Oh, look at Alfie. Isn't he hot in that? Do you mind? Come here, big fella, eh?
Moved in since when?
Oh, it's not for long. My visa expires in 5 months. I had to move flats last week. Couldn't get a 5-month lease, so Romy helped me out. I'm another one of her lost causes.
Christ, you can't turn your back on this house.
And yet you still do.
Last day. We're going out for a drink. Do you fancy coming?
No. Sort of busy.
Anything interesting?
No. Just this friend. I might not go.
Is it a date?
Might be.
Have a good time. Good for you. If you don't go, we'll be in the Feathers at 7.
Hello, it's me, Vince.
Dead phone, I left a message.
Is this what you do on Saturday? Just call around and apologise for the week?
The childminder's a bit stupid with messages sometimes.
Get an answer phone.
I had one. Robert took it.
Here, get yourself a new one.
The car needs a service. The clutch is gone.
How much?
200. And Tom's nagging for software. He wants a new graphics package or something.
Just call it 500, yeah?
Fine. Oh, and Mum and Dad are getting a divorce.
Yeah, yeah. Funny joke.
And you've been to see them, have you? You've driven all of 10 miles to go and see them. Of course, they don't tell you. They don't tell Golden Boy. Me, I get it all.
What have they said?
Of course you could just write them a check, because that makes everything all right, doesn't it? If you don't believe me, go and see them. I'll draw you a map.
Honestly, I don't mind. We could go down Castlefield.
You like this place, you said?
It's your day. They're doing what you like.
Problem is, starts to look the same. Well, I spent 3 years in Sydney, and it was fantastic. The scene's huge. There's hundreds of clubs, and then I come over here, I travelled halfway across the world, and what do I find? Same men standing in the same clubs.
Yeah. What's the same?
The men.
Right. Same as what?
Same as Sydney. She was at the funeral, that one.
Woman,
that one there, she was putting half the food in a handbag.
Hey, where the fuck have you been?
Hey, Stuart, Cameron, you've met?
That's right, yeah, we met by the buffet. I like that buffet, it was fucking excellent.
You're pissed.
So get me a drink. Direct accounts. Some of it's shit, but some of the clients are good, you know? Manchester, indie labels, that sort of thing.
What for?
Anything. There's always something better, isn't there? Just waiting to come along. You know that feeling?
Here you go.
Took your time, I missed you.
Oh, don't mind me.
Where's he going?
Up his own ass.
There it is. Not much. Do you want a drink?
You having one?
I'll just have one. I can't stay up. I'll have to chuck you out. I'm working first thing.
Gin and tonic.
Yep. Gin and tonic. Sorry about Stuart. I haven't seen him that pissed in ages.
Some friend. He was making a pass at me.
No. He's always like that.
Vince, I've been around the block. He was making a pass.
No, really. He wouldn't fancy you.
Thanks.
No, I mean... it's just types, you know? He wouldn't.
He did. Nice. Nice place. Ah, Doctor Who. We used to get that. Scared me as a kid. The one with the shop window dummies. Oh, and that one with the maggots. That was good. How many tapes have you got? You're one of those anorak blokes.
Your tapes!
Sod the tapes!
I just thought there might be the chance to shag one of the staff.
Oh, Australian, very nice.
Hey, Irene, Al Vince has got himself a fella.
Very nice, too.
I said hello, look at me!
Fuck him! Just fuck him!
Trouble at home, your mother be shagging about!
Shut up!
Bastard!
What the fuck do you mean?